New Age, humanism, all those from Satan. There isn't but one life giver, and it's not my word, I'm reading from the Bible, and that is Jesus Christ. Jesus said, the Word of God said, for the wages of sin is death, a separation from God, spiritual death. The Bible talks about two deaths, physical death and spiritual death. We're going to all die physically if Jesus tarries. If Jesus tarries, if I'm not called away or if I'm not translated into heaven, I'm going to go the way of the grave. Amen. There have been people that lived on this earth that we know about. We know about two of them in the Bible, but there's been others also that we don't know about it that never died physically. They were just translated. God just called them up. Hallelujah. If God wants to do it, He can. He don't have to get your permission for it. He's God. Amen. Amen. He can do what He wants. There's been some people that pleased Him so much. Enoch, come on up to heaven. And Enoch was, God just called him on up. Why? He had this testimony. The Bible says he pleased God. Amen. He pleased God. Enoch had that testimony. He pleased God. God said, come on up to heaven. And then we know about Elijah. Elijah. We know about him. Praise God, he was caught. A chariot of fire picked him up. He told Elisha, bye. Right. Amen. Yeah. And then we know about Moses, that God buried him.
Right.
Hallelujah. Ain't that awesome? God is a mighty God. But I want you to know sin is not worth going to hell for.
Right.
Somebody says, yeah, but I'm a good person, are you? The Bible says in Romans 3:23, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, every one of us. And that speaking, when you tell me that you're a good person, pride is just smiling right back at you.
Yeah.
I'm a good person. Yeah, and you're full of pride. And that's how Satan fell. The Bible says Satan fell from heaven because he was lifted up in pride. Amen. Thank God for the shed blood of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my Savior forever. Jesus said in John 14:6, well, let's just turn there for a moment. Go with me to John. I quote scripture sometimes, but let's look at it. John 14:6. Hallelujah. Isn't he wonderful?
Yes.
Well, let's just begin with verse 1 through verse 6. John's Gospel, the 14th chapter. Let not your heart be troubled. He's speaking to his disciples. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, and Father's house is heaven, by the way. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. Listen to this. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there you may be also. He loves you. And whether I go, you know. And the way you know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest. And how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way. I am the way. The truth and the life. No man. I want you to notice what Jesus said. No man, no man, no man cometh unto the Father but by who? Buddha? Muhammad? Islam? New Age? Your way of thinking. It's not my way of thinking. It's what Jesus said. You know what the Lord revealed to me one day? John 3:16. We all know what John 3:16 says. God so loved the world. God made a way for the Hindus. He made a way for the Muslims. Every nationality. Jesus made a way for them. Jesus made a way for every people in the world. And get this, it's God's way and not our way. But so many times we want to do it. No, this is what I believe about it. But what does the Bible say about it? Are you hearing me? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. Jesus Christ is the only way into heaven. There is no other way. But there are many people that are blinded, and we're fixing to look at that. If you would, go to 2 Corinthians chapter 4 real quickly. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, look at verse 3 and 4. Hallelujah, isn't the Lord wonderful? 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3 and 4, he says, but if our gospel be hid, that is, if we hide the gospel, we don't share the gospel with anyone. If our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are what? In whom? The God of this world. Who is the God of this world? See, a lot of people think God's running the show. Did you know that? A lot of people, if you ask them who is the God, no, the earth belongs to the Lord, but he's not running it yet because he gave it to Adam, and Adam committed high treason and handed it over to Satan. But a lot of people don't know that. That's why all this sin and filth and ugliness and pornography and homosexuality and whoremongers and men and murderers and thieves and liars and corruption in politics and corruption in states and corruption across the world. Why? It's because Satan is running things here in this world system. That's why we are to pray, as God said. Are you hearing me? Hello? But one of these days when Adam's lease runs out, and the next thing that God does anything about Satan is when the angel comes and puts him in the bottomless pit for 1,000 years.
Yes.
And then after 1,000 years, he'll be loose for a little season. But Jesus is going to reign. When Jesus reigns on this earth, there'll be no filth, there'll be no sin, there'll be righteousness.
Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. That day is approaching. Just like the day has come now that you're sitting here in this present moment in time. That day is coming. But till then, we have to pray, amen, that God will move upon certain officials, and we'll have to pray that God will move upon certain people and draw them, because if we don't pray, look at the rest of this verse. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, it says, in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not. Now, I want you to know something. The reason why a lot of people that do not believe in Christ is because their mind, they don't have the same mind as you and I. Their minds have actually been blinded from seeing the truth of the gospel by Satan himself and evil spirits, demons, devils, imps. They blind people's minds from seeing what you see. And that's why the Bible tells us in Hebrews, how shall we escape if we neglect our salvation? I have seen Christians neglect their salvation. I don't want to get into it, but we just talked about over there in Romans 6:22. Fruit unto what? Holiness. Amen. I have met people that claim to be Christians. You couldn't tell no difference at all. They live just like the world, act like the world, talk like the world, hate like the world, partiality like the world. There was nothing different except they just went into church and a lot of pretense. Are you hearing me? Thank you, brother. A lot of pretense. Jesus called them hypocrites in his day. The Sadducees, the Pharisees. He says he called them hypocrites. That's what he did. Because they make long prayers in the synagogues that they may be seen of men. They fast. They disfigured their faces in front of public when they went to fast. Why? Where they can have the praise of people instead of God. But Jesus said, when you fast, be not like the hypocrites are. He called them religious bunch, hypocrites. Let me tell you, thank you, Lord, that's good. Here's what the Lord just brought to me, and I'm going to tell you, God knows you better than you know yourself.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, our fruit is to be holiness unto Him. And I'd rather have the approval of God than I would man, and you should want the approval of God than man. But we've got a lot of man pleasers and people pleasers in the church that want to please people instead of God. Listen, oh, thank you, Lord. And here's what the Lord just gave. If you set out to seek and to please man, you will have the disapproval of God. But if you set out to seek and have the approval of God, then people will leave you. Not every... Hey, listen, when you stand with God, not everybody's going to stand with you, because there's a lot of people, even in the church, that won't stand with Jesus. Are you hearing me? Every church should be filled in McGee, Mississippi. Every church should be filled. Every denomination. But there's something else that has their heart through the Messiah. the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Yeah.
And He knows you better than you know yourself.
Right.
There's no hiding from Him. I've heard of people that was called up to heaven. Some of them I've been around, some of them I read about. And when they were called up, when God looked at them, there's no hiding anything from Him. It's like He saw through them. He knew all about them, everything about. You cannot hide nothing from God, the Almighty. When He looks at you, He knows all about you.
Right.
See, we do pretty good sometimes hiding things. You know, but listen, but when God looks at you and I, He knows all about you. And a lot of times God's speaking to our hearts about things, but we're too prideful to repent. And get things right. But there's coming a day when that flesh that you live in right then is going, it's going to breathe this last breath. You're going to be out of it. Don't neglect this salvation. Because hell is not worth it. You know, some people here, we live 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. That's not even a drop in the bucket in eternity. There's people that's been in hell for 3,000 or 4,000 years now. Are you hearing me? I mean, even when Jesus in His time, He talked about in the 16th chapter of Luke about a rich man and a beggar. And there were people in hell when he said a certain rich man. That was not a parable. He was telling a true story there. We might look at that. A lot of people, I was talking to a fellow not too long ago, and he said he was talking to someone about the Scriptures, and he was telling them what the Scriptures meant. You know, like I told you earlier, John 14:6, Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the..." This guy wants to say, well, let's see what that means. See what that means? Can you not read? It means what it says. He always wanted, well, let's see, what's the interpretation of that? I mean, I've been a fifth grader, and some say, can you tell me what that means? And a fifth grader say, that means Jesus is the only way. It's amazing how many people want to put an interpretation on Scripture when it's trying to speak to you.
Right.
He was just speaking to His disciples. He said, hey, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. No man comes unto the Father except by me. There ain't, you don't have to put any kind of interpretation on it.
Right.
Exactly what He said. He's the only way.
Yeah. Right.
Amen. And Satan blinds a lot of people. And you know, we understand that 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4, it tells us, it says that, in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not. Now here it is, here's how that darkness is removed. Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, now notice that.
Yeah.
Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. We preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants, for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, hath shined in our hearts, to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
The only way that people can see and understand is through the gospel.
Right.
If you never share it, they'll never know.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
What does the Bible say?
Amen.
I like that. Lest the light of the glorious gospel. I preached a sermon one time years ago. The glorious gospel of Christ. This is the glorious gospel of Christ.
Yeah.
This is what we preach is the glorious gospel. And it's the glorious gospel of Christ that moves all darkness.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I know who I serve. Glory to God. Amen. It's Jesus Christ, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, the Son of the living God, born into this world of a virgin. God manifested in the flesh. And she gave birth to Jesus. And man had nothing to do with his conception. It was God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He is the Son of the living God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And I belong to Him.
Amen.
And wherever He leads me, He'll go. I will follow.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. We have to understand that Satan is real and he blinds minds. And the only thing that can remove that is the gospel, the glorious gospel. Amen. It's not my opinion. It's not your opinion. Take my opinion, your opinion, and throw them in the garbage and burn them. It's what the Word of God says. And that's what's wrong so many people putting their opinions on Scripture instead of accepting Scripture.
Amen.
Well, this is what I want to say about it. I don't want to hear what you have to say about it. And I don't want to give you what I think about it. I want to give you what the Bible says about it.
Yes.
If the Bible says it, I believe it. That settles it. Don't try to talk me out of it. Now, where's James at? There he is. Judy's not here today, is she? And I will use him. She must not be feeling well or something. Okay. Well, Judy brought her granddaughter here. Oh, wonderful testimony. She had epileptic seizures since 3 to 13. 9 years, right? From 3 to 13. 9 years, huh? She brought her daughter up to the Lord. I knew what I was going to do because I believe the gospel.
Yes.
I believe the gospel. I don't believe the opinions and theories of men. They have talked that away. They have talked it away. Say, that's done away with today. I don't believe that. I don't believe that. I believe it's for us today. Well, she just marched up here, this beautiful, is she 13? 13-year-old girl with her mother. I said, what'd you come for? And her mother was telling me she had epileptic seizures. Well, I knew right then. I said, she's going to get rid of the devil, wasn't
it? Amen. Glory to God.
God didn't put epilepsy on no child. God never has put epilepsy on no child. Never. Never has Jesus put epilepsy. He always healed them. And so I laid my hands on this child in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Commanded the devil to go and commanded the seizures to grow. Commanded her body to be healed in Jesus' name. Something similar to those words. They took her back to the doctor and they tried to induce the seizure.
Amen.
That's his stepdaughter. I mean, a granddaughter, by the way.
Yeah.
They tried to, didn't they? The doctors tried to induce the seizure. Couldn't do it. Did you know you can put any name on any demon?
Right.
Anyway, she had to go back to the doctor again. She went back, totally set free.
Yeah.
She ain't had a seizure since she left here.
Yeah.
Jesus is the healer.
Yeah.
Had him for 9 years.
Yes.
9. But when she left out of this place, no wonder the devil talked to Bridget and said, stay away from Dennis Phillips. She didn't even know my last name. No devils want nobody coming in this place. And hearing the gospel.
Right.
And then Adrian, you know, Mandy and Adrian, they were sitting right over there. They got up because they're going with the play. About half the bunch over here left. They got a lot to do though. Adrian said one of his cousins that's out in sin, drugs, they was getting ready to come to this church one Sunday morning. This church. She said she heard a voice speak to her and says, don't go down there to that church. She thought it was God speaking to her. It was God. The God of this world.
Yes. Right.
Amen. I said it was.
Amen.
But I believe the gospel. I believe the glorious gospel of Christ is for us today as when Jesus walked the earth. I remember not too long ago. Now, sometimes with me, not too long ago, it could be 10, 5, 3 years ago. That might not be with you. But that's not too long ago with me because time flies by quick. And it's certainly not too long ago for Jesus. Because he said the time is short.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so it ain't too long with Jesus. 100 years with Jesus is not too long ago. Amen. Well, anyway, I was praying for a lady and I was in a hurry. Because I wanted to get home. And I was praying for a lady and I just laid my hand on her. You know, I was about to go out the door like this and pray for her. And the Lord spoke to me and says, lay both your hands on her. And so I laid both of my hands on her and I prayed and rebuked the sickness and commanded to leave in the name of Jesus. I got down the road in my truck and I get a phone call. She says, I'm better. It's gone.
Amen.
I'm better. I said, well, praise the Lord. Well, the Lord, I had one hand on her and the Holy Ghost spoke to me and says, put your other hand.
Yes.
The Bible says, these signs shall follow them that believe in my name. They shall lay hands.
Hands.
That's right.
Yes.
But God wants to move through your hands.
Yes.
The devil don't want you to believe it. The devil wants to mess your squirrely mind up and say, none of that's for us today. Amen. That's what's wrong with the church today. We got too many squirrely minds.
Yeah.
They believe religion instead of New Testament.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God I wasn't so filled with a lot of religion. Amen. And then you got that put on. Go on. We come to, he knows what you sound like anyway. Speak to him like you do anybody else.
Amen.
God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I says, Lord, I'm going to get a little bit undignified. That's the way it is, son. Glory to God. I'm enjoying it. But we go to some church, you sit down. We come to you today, Lord, I'd rather go outside and do something active than here put off. Put off. God knows what you sound like when you're at home. Why don't you just go ahead and talk to Him how you sound?
Amen.
He knows what you like when you're at home.
Amen.
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 Don't look at me so sanctified. I get a little undignified in here. I don't have all religion in my mind. That's why God can move. Because so many people, they train their intellects at the expense of their spirits.
Come on.
And they go to seminary or cemetery.
Come on, bro.
And they take all that the... Now, some schooling's good. I'm not against education. But some of that stuff you need to leave out.
Right.
That's what ruins a lot of people. What did Jesus talk about the Pharisees and the Sadducees? You go to proselyte someone that crosses seas and lands and you make them a twofold child of the devil. That's what he told them, didn't he? Well, religion's not going to get you nowhere.
That's right.
I'm not a religious man. I'm a saved man.
Amen.
There's a difference. Even though I believed in Jesus, listen, this is a lot of people in the church, what I'm fixing to say. When I was in the bars and pool halls, I was in church one time. I believed in Jesus, but my mind was blinded.
Right.
Your mind can become blind. You can be in church right now, hearing this gospel, but the Lord just quickened me saying, and that darkness is being removed.
Yeah.
There might be somebody right now, Lord just quickened me. I'm preaching the gospel to you,
yeah.
And that darkness is being removed right now.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
But don't turn Jesus away.
Praise God.
Don't turn Jesus away. Well, anyway, you can be in a church and there's been people to come to a church, walk with God, and they started dabbling in sin.
Yeah.
Maybe doing something they know they shouldn't be doing. And all of a sudden their minds are blinded again.
Yes.
Even though, see, you can come to this church, you can hear a message preached, but that won't get you to heaven.
Come on. Yeah. That's right.
The Bible says, be doers of the word.
Amen.
And not just hearers only.
Amen.
Amen. If you don't do the word and worship Jesus, the devil will come and try to blind your mind again. And then that's when a lot of people begin to think, well, the Lord don't love me. And I'm just not cut out for this Christian walk. They start listening to the lies of the devil and they leave. They leave the Father. Can I tell you, Jesus loves you and the devil hates you. Let me tell you this. Now, I don't believe in giving no glory to the devil. So don't think I'm giving him any glory, but he's good at deception. He's a master at deception. And he knows where to get to people at. If it's through a man, a woman, a boy, a girl, through a desire of the flesh, or whatever it might be, he's a master at it. And that's why the Bible says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, he knows you. Let me tell you, the devil knows you. I say, God, now he don't know you like God does. The only thing the devil knows about you is what he sees you do and what you like.
Yeah.
You know, when somebody sees something, you know, on TV, maybe on TV or through a magazine or some that is sinful, and your eyes begin to like that and indulge in that, the devil sees that. He says, their desire. He works with that. See, the devil knows if you like something sinful. And if you do, guess what he's going to trip you up with? If you like something that's sinful, Satan's fixing to come after you.
Right.
And he's not going to quit till you're destroyed. Listen to me. Satan has no pity for you. His goal is to destroy you, make your life miserable, bind you, keep you bound, and your final destiny is in hell with him. That's his destiny. He wants to blind you and trip you up. He does it with drugs. He does it with alcohol. He does it with women. He does it with men. He does it with anything that he can bring someone's way to entice them with. He said, here's the bait. He'll bring the bait to them. And if they grab it, it's just like I told you about that Indian man, that Indian minister that Lester Sumrall was talking about. Lester Sumrall knew this man. Thank God I come up under some good teachers. Amen. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But anyway, this was an Indian. An Indian man in India. And God was using him over there in India, casting out devils, laying hands on the sick, preaching the gospel, people coming from Hinduism unto Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. And all of a sudden, this minister that was an Indian, all of a sudden, this beautiful lady, Indian girl, one time I was preaching and ministering in Vicksburg, Mississippi, there at Lighthouse Assembly of God, and I had an Indian girl to come up and receive Christ. She was all in white, beautiful girl. And I thought to myself, praise God, Lord, I was able to lead an Indian, she's around 18 or 19, up to the Lord. It feels good to lead someone that was in another religion. Well, anyway, he was over there in the ministry, and all of a sudden, Lester Sumrall talks about how this beautiful girl, Indian girl, appeared to him. Beautiful Indian girl. And this guy was related to Lester Sumrall. What happened to it? And she said, here, take me, have me. I'm yours. And all of a sudden, the temptation was so strong because she was beautiful. I mean, what is a temptation to a man? Minister or not? Dear God, I don't know about some of these other guys. They kind of screw loose. You know, like boys or men like men. But anyway, that's a devil that needs to be cast out. But anyway, he said all of a sudden this Indian man closed his eyes like this because the temptation was so strong with this young, beautiful girl coming up to him. He closed his eyes. It was just so strong. All of a sudden he opened his eyes back up. She disappeared. The Holy Ghost spoke to him and said, if that was a demon spirit, if you would have took hold of that thing, it would have destroyed you. See what sin does? See what the devil wanted to do to him? He was going around snatching souls out of hell from Hinduism to Christ, casting devils out, laying hands on the sick. People were being set free. And a demon spirit was trying to stop him from interrupting his kingdom.
Amen.
And the Lord spoke to him and said, if you'd have took hold of that thing, it would have destroyed you. What destroyed people? What did God tell Israel that would destroy them? Sin. He told Israel, he said, sin shall be the ruin of you. What ruins people? Friends, the Bible says over there in Romans 6:22 that we should offer unto God the fruit of holiness. You start, the wages of sin is death. That's right in the Christians. God said at the end, he said, if you'll overcome to the end, to the churches in Revelation, I will not blot your name out of my book. Amen? No, my Bible tells me in Hebrews 12:14, follow peace with all men. All men, not just white men, black men, yellow men, Indian men. Amen. Follow peace with all men. Amen. And holiness without which no man shall see the Lord.
Amen. Right.
Or hear me, that's Hebrews 12:14. That's the Word of God. Now listen to me what happened to me. I love the Spirit of God. I love Jesus. I love the Holy Ghost. I couldn't preach to you this morning if it wasn't for the Holy Ghost. The reason why I'm moving like I am is because of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Amen. Whoever God calls, He equips.
Amen.
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 God doesn't call nobody without giving them the tools.
Amen.
Well, anyway, I come in one night around after 2 o'clock in the morning, I believe it was. Hey, don't listen to the mercy of God. I'm backslid. I'm out of fellowship. I'm back in the pool halls. I come in there and I sit on my day bed and I was chilling because I'm buzzing a little bit. And I was just sitting there just chilling after 2 o'clock in the morning. Nobody in the room with me, I thought. You know what I mean? I'm sitting there by myself upstairs and I had a little Miller light with a little bug, a little cool string. You know, full light on. And I'm just sitting there on the day bed and the Lord came into the room and spoke this to me. Listen to me very carefully. If the devil, now remember what he tried it with Jesus. Here's what the Lord spoke to me. If the devil was to come into your room right now, listen to me, everyone, because I want you to put yourself in this. Here's what was spoken to me. I'm out of fellowship with God. I'm in filth. I'm in sin. I'm undone. I'm back in the pool halls gambling. And here's what was spoken to me. If the devil was to come to your room right now and offer you fame, fortune, wealth, popularity, women, But all you had to do is sell your soul out to him. Would you do it? And that's all he said to me. And I began to think about it. I thought about it for a moment. I'd be honest with you, I was being real. If the devil was there and offered me all that, that's what people want. That's what I was striving to do when my state course was, is to get me up there where he can get me endorsements. So I was thinking about that. And then I remembered a verse of scripture where Jesus said, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? And then I thought about that verse of scripture. I said, oh no, Lord, I wouldn't sell my soul out to him. No, I wouldn't do it. Because I know my time to die would come. Right here. When I said that, the Lord was waiting for my response. And the Lord spoke this. Why are you serving him now and he hasn't given you any of those things? What? Why are you... Well, no, he only said it once. But he was waiting on my response. And I told him, no, I wouldn't do it. And I was already in the back in the world. He said, why are you serving him now? I was in the bars. I was in the pool halls. I was in sin. And the Lord said, he hasn't given you none of those things, and you're serving him now. I said, Lord, here's what I told the Lord. I'm a fool. See how Satan had me blinded? I told the Lord, no, I wouldn't serve Satan or sell my soul out for popularity and the world's goods. I wouldn't do it. But yet I'm backslidden. I'm practicing ungodliness. And the Lord said, why are you serving him now? And he hasn't given you any of those things. My mind is blinded. How many minds are blinded today by Satan? My Bible tells me, follow peace with all men and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Let's all stand.